Leander here, and today we're going to learn how to make a very simple web page using HTML. So this video is for complete beginners in web programming. First, we need a text editor to write our HTML code. If you're using Windows, you have a text editor. It's called Notepad. Or if you're one of my Japanese viewers, it's going to be called Memo. So go ahead and open up your text editor. Now let's save this blank page as our web page. Just put it right on the desktop, call it page, and we add .html to tell the computer that this is an HTML file to be read by a web browser. Let's just save that. And here is our web page. If I click on it, it'll open up in my default web browser. And of course, there's nothing on the page yet. So let's add something. Hi. Save that. Go back, refresh our web browser, and here we go. Our text appears. Let's add some more text. This is my first web page. Save that. Go back, refresh your browser, and uh-oh. Something's different. Let's try adding some more return spaces. Still no change. So this is the big difference between just writing in regular text and coding in HTML. With HTML, we have to use code to organize information on the page, including breaking text into two different lines. So one way to break this text into two different lines is to use the break tag. And to do that, you just make these brackets here and add BR. Save that. And now our text is broken into two different lines. Let's add some more breaks. Now, how about we add a heading for the top of our page? My page. This doesn't really look like a heading yet, but we can use some HTML code to make it look better. So in brackets, we write H1, and then at the end of our heading, we write the same thing, but we put this slash here before the H. That looks better. Let's go back and take another look at our heading tags. We have an opening tag and a closing tag. This closing tag is really important. Let's see what happens if we forget it. The browser doesn't know where to stop making text into a heading, so everything becomes a heading. Let's put that closing tag back on. Oops, I'm forgetting something. Let's go back and take a look. Do you see what I forgot? That's right, the slash. And now we're back to normal. So, some HTML code is like our break tag. You don't need any closing tag. But most HTML is like our code for our heading, and you need a closing tag. So, that's something to be careful about. Next, let's make a link. We'll put it at the bottom of the page. And the tag for a link is not L, it's actually A. And A stands for anchor. So it's like you're anchoring your page to another page. And you close that with slash A. I'm going to make the text for my link, find another page because I'm going to link to Google search. Next, we need to add the reference to the link so that it'll go to the Google search page. To do that, we go back to the opening tag and we add href, which stands for hypertext reference, then equals and double quotations. And in those double quotations, we're going to put the web address or URL of Google search. So I've added the URL, including the HTTPS and www part. We save that, refresh our page, and here's our link. If I click it, it takes us to Google search. Now, what if we want to link to another page that we've made on our site? To find out, we need to make another page. So let's go back to our text editor, new, type 2 here, and save this as page2.html in the same folder, our desktop. And here's our new page. Now let's go back to our original page, open, desktop, where is it? Oh, I have to do this, show all files. Here it is. Now all we do is change this URL here to the name of our page 2 file, which is page2.html. Don't forget the .html part. And I'm going to change our text to page 2. And save that. Go back here. And now when we click on the link, it takes us to page 2. Next, how about we add an image? To do that, first we need to find an image. And to make things easy, I'm just going to paste this on the desktop. Now we go back to our text editor, add a couple breaks, and we use the image tag. And then to tell the browser which image we're talking about, we type src, which means source, equals double quotations, and now we put the name of the file, the image file, which is Fuji. Save that, refresh, and our image isn't showing up. What's going on? Let's go back and look at our code. We wrote Fuji for the name of our image file. And that's what our computer tells us the name is. But maybe our computer's hiding something from us. See, it calls our web page just page, but we know the real name is page.html. That part of the file name after the dot is called the file extension, and it tells the computer or browser what to do with the file. So it's really important. To show the file extension, we need to go to our desktop folder settings, go to view, and click file name extensions. And now we can see that Fuji isn't just Fuji, it's Fuji.png. So let's add that .png to Fuji for our source. And now our image shows up, but it's really huge. So how do we change the size? Well, we can go back to our code, and in the image tag, after our source, we can add width equals double quotations 500 px. px stands for pixels. Save that. And now our image is 500 pixels wide. Much better. If we wanted to, we could also change the height. So I'll just try something here. Height equals 50 pixels. Save that. And now it looks really weird. So generally, it's a good idea to just do one or the other, width or height, and the computer will automatically adjust the image. to make it the right proportions. So I'm just going to get rid of height. Okay, our page is starting to take shape. Now, let me give you a quick tip about text. So far, to put text on a new line, I've just been using breaks. But there's actually a better way to do this, and that is using the paragraph tag. So let me show you how that works. So for hi, I'll just put a tag like this, p, and then at the end, slash p. And now we can get rid of this. We can get rid of that. Save it. Refresh. And I guess we had an extra break here. There. It looks about the same, but it's more concise. And the paragraph tag tells the browser, hey, this is a paragraph of text, which is different from, for example, an image or some other element on a page. So that's why we try to use the paragraph tag instead of just doing a lot of breaks. So let me fix up the rest of the text using the paragraph tag. Okay, so we only have one break left, and that's just to get a little extra white space after the heading. But everything else now has paragraph tags. So let's see what that looks like in the browser. And there we are. Looks about the same. But our code is more concise. There's another thing we can do to make our code easier to read. Check out this last line. It's a little hard to read. We have a link element inside of a paragraph element. To make it easier to read, we can put the inside element on its own line and tab it over, and then close the outside element right below where that element starts. This way, we can kind of see what element is inside what other element, and it makes it really easy for us to figure out if we need to close something or not. So I recommend always tabbing over nested elements like this. So far, we've been dealing with just the main visible part of our web page. This is called the body. And we actually need to indicate that this code is all part of the body element by adding the body tags. So up here, type body in brackets, and then we close the element down here. And because all of this stuff is inside of the body element, to make it readable, we should tab it all over. Adding the body tags doesn't change the way our page is displayed right now, but it will help the browser to read elements that don't belong in the body. For example, the title. If you look at the top of the tab here, we don't have a title yet. So let's add one. Before we can add a title, we need to give our page a head in addition to the body. So add the head tag, close the element, and inside of this head element, we add the title. A simple web page. Save it. Now, our page has a title. There are just two more things we should add to our code to make sure that browsers can easily read it. First, we should put all of our HTML code inside of HTML tags. So we take all of this stuff, put it all inside of HTML tags, and to make it easy for us to read, we should tab everything over. The last thing we should add is a declaration of our document type. To do that, we write in brackets exclamation mark, and then doc type in all caps, and then in lowercase HTML. Adding HTML tags and declaring the doc type won't really change how your page looks, but it will help your page load correctly and quickly in the browser. So it's a good idea to make sure you add those. And now, our simple web page is complete. Congratulations, you know basic HTML. But there are a few things we should do differently the next time we code. First, we should put all of our web pages into a single folder that's just for our website. Why don't we do that right now? Second, we should name our main page, not page, but index. index.html. Third, we should not use Internet Explorer as our default browser. Instead, I recommend using Google Chrome. Google Chrome is much better for web programming. If you don't have it, I'm going to put the download link below this video. So go ahead and download it and install it. And then just go to one of your HTML files, right click, go to properties, and change the browser to Google Chrome. And now our page opens up in Chrome. The last change we should make is we should stop using our computer's default text editor for our programming. There are a lot better text editors out there for web programming. My favorite is called Sublime Text, and there's a free version available. So I'm just going to include the link to this program below. Download it, install it. Things will be much easier for you. Let me quickly show you what I mean. If I go to Sublime Text and I open up the file we just made, it looks like this. Compare to Notepad. Which is easier to read? Over here, Sublime Text automatically makes HTML tags red. It makes text white. A lot easier to read. And here's another thing. Remember when we had to tab all this stuff over one line at a time? That was pretty tedious. But with Sublime Text, we can just highlight everything we want to tab over and just hit tab, and it all tabs over. And if we go too far, hold down shift and hit tab again, and we can bring it back. That's just one of the neat tricks you can do with Sublime Text. So I highly recommend it. And that's it. Thanks for watching, guys, and enjoy programming in HTML.